Shannon Spake, you're walking into the Lions' Den this morning. Do you know what the big story is? I know the Dodgers won. I know you know the Dodgers won. But have you seen the Justin Turner news?
Yeah. I was just talking to Danny about that. What, I mean, the world that we're living in right now, right, Clay? What a crazy place that a guy can't go out and celebrate with his team, and the fact that that's like sort of the overarching story this morning instead of the fact that they won the World Series.
For the first time in 32 years, I think the number one story is going to be Justin Turner went on the – first of all, the Major League Baseball even having a system in which you can get results in the game for the test seems
so
like a
weird.
Pretty big flaw. And we can't say at this point, it's not like it's the first game of the season. They've had an entire year, season now of baseball to get this testing system sufficient. And now they don't even have that many guys to actually test, whatever it is, you know, 100 total, you know, probably way less than that, whatever the rosters are, 28, I think, whatever they were for the World Series. And then the support staff around them, I can't imagine it's more than 50 or so people that they are testing for each team, meaning they're only having to do like 100 tests at this point. It's not like there's all 30 Major League Baseball teams that they're constantly testing. Like, this seems like they're at the home stretch. It should have been super easy to get this testing done.
Yeah, and I don't know much about the testing policy in Major League Baseball. Obviously, I know a lot more about the NFL right now and NASCAR, obviously, what they're doing. But I just find it strange that like they find out during the game. And listen, I've seen a lot of false positives. I have friends that have tested false positive. I mean, obviously, it's happened in the NFL. So if that was it, then obviously that's what we're going to be talking about. But I just find it strange that they find out mid-game about a positive test and not before the game, or why do they test on game day if they've already tested the day? It's just kind of, I don't know. There's a lot to sort of peel back the layers of the story.
How lucky is Major League Baseball that the Dodgers won game 6? Because can you imagine if it was tied up 3-3 and the storyline was Justin Turner tested positive? I think they'd have to suspend game 7 for a week or more.
I don't know how they would deal with that. Again, like, what if it was a false positive, right? Could he then get the 2 consecutive negative tests? And I think I heard you this morning, did he already take 2 positives? Like,
there were
definitely positive?
Yeah, so he's had 2 positive tests. That doesn't mean that he couldn't have had 2 false positive tests, right? But he's had at least, unlike, say, Nick Saban, who tested false positive and then had 5 additional tests that were more accurate and determined that he had never had the virus. Justin Turner has had, at least according to this report, 2 different false positives.
Well,
I mean, sorry, 2 different positives.
They would have definitely had to suspend game 7, right? Because everybody in that clubhouse would have been around him, and they would have had to test everybody, just like what we've seen with the NFL, right? Some games having to be pushed back days until everybody that was around them. And I don't know, are they wearing sort of the distance monitors that the NFL is wearing? I don't know the process with Major League Baseball as much as I do with NFL.
All right, you are married, you have 2 children. If your husband had been on the LA Dodgers, Justin Turner's wife was on the field, they kissed. She knew he was positive. Mm-hmm. They kissed for their photo with the World Series trophy.
Crazy we're having this conversation,
would
right?
Would you like, have kissed so your husband if he were positive for COVID? Could have been a false positive. And you knew how much it meant to him to win the World Series trophy on the field.
I mean, it just depends. Have I seen my husband like in days prior
I think
to
they've
this,
been,
right?
And, I think the families, you guys can look this up, but I think the families have been able to be, I'm not sure if it's the full families, but I think the spouses and wives and girlfriends, whatever, have been able to be with the players for the past several days.
I mean, maybe even the past several weeks. Yeah, she's probably like, if you have it, I already have it anyways.
That's probably what she's thinking on some level.
And I think that's what most people would think, right? I mean, I do know people who are like travel with NFL and are super safe when they get back and they're around their families. But I think that if you're around them and like you're like, okay, well, we probably already all have it anyways. I think that that's probably what she was thinking.
So would you have kissed your husband?
I don't know. It depends on if he was nice to me that day, Clay. It all depends.
That's actually the perfect answer. So what I said is we're having a Halloween party on Friday. We're doing our normal Halloween party that we have done for several years. it seems to me there is a desperate desire for many people out there to get back to normal. If you do not want to go to a party, then you certainly don't have to do it. I did a tailgate event for the Alabama-Tennessee game. We had a lot of pictures. I answered questions. I signed some books. Like, I am trying to live my life as normal. I don't plan. I got tested Wednesday at the White House. I was negative.
Mm-hmm.
I heard
you went to the White House.
Yeah.
I've seen some of those pictures.
Yeah, I've seen some of those pictures. So we'll get to that maybe in a sec. But I have I previously talked about on the radio show that early on in the pandemic, I think it was like June, relatively speaking, there was drive-through testing. And I still think they have drive-through testing, if I'm not mistaken, in mm-hmm. Tennessee. And I was like, I want to know what one of these tests is like. So I went and got tested. I have tested negative twice. Now, there are months between them. One in June, mm-hmm. I believe it was. One in October. I have no plans to ever get tested for COVID again for the rest of my life. If I feel sick for any reason, I'll stay at home and hopefully get better. Whenever there's a vaccine, I'll go get the vaccine. I get a flu shot every year because I travel a decent amount, and I come into contact a lot of times with more people than your average person would, and I don't want to get the flipping flu. So that's my plan for the fall going into winter. And all of those things are personal decisions. But I also said, if someone knew they had COVID, I wouldn't want them to come to my Halloween party. So I can understand some people being like, yeah, he probably shouldn't be on the field since he thinks that he has COVID. So I can see both sides of this argument. And about 71% of my crew says they have no problem with over 20,000 people voting. 71% say they have no problem with him on the field. 29% say they do. And by the way, he also played almost an entire baseball game already. So what is 5 or 10 minutes on the baseball field going to do to increase the risk, given the fact that he played all the way through the eighth inning already?
I gotta think like those players, again, same thing, right? We've been around you the last, you know, months. You've been in the clubhouse. You've been around us. We've been eating together. We've been doing this together. We've been doing that together. Like, you got to think like, yeah, I don't know. What's one more second, right? What's 5 more minutes as you come onto the field? But listen, Clay, I am with you. I would totally understand if somebody was like, no, right? If someone did not feel comfortable with that, I 100% support that, because I'm just like you. I don't want someone who knows that they have it. Like, that's the biggest thing. I get tested every single week, right?
Yeah.
And so the biggest thing for me is that, like, I don't want to get somebody else sick. That's why I wear my masks. That's why when I'm in my meetings with everybody, I wear my masks. I do all the things that I need to do so that if, in fact, I were to come in contact with it, I wouldn't get someone
sick. How does
sick.
Your
that's
testing work? Thing.
I actually have like a doctor who I Zoom with. And so I do it at home once a week, every Monday morning, take my test and send it in. And so, yeah.
Oh, so you take the test on Monday and then you mm-hmm. don't take another test. It's just every Monday after you're back from wherever you go. Yeah.
Every week I get tested. Yes.
Okay. So you this week are going to be back down near where you grew up in South Florida. You grew up a Dolphins
yes.
fan. Tua's first
yep.
game back. I believe there are going to be Dolphin fans present there, right?
Yes. And
have you been?
I'm really excited about this storyline, yeah.
Yeah, I know you were in Pittsburgh. How many different stadiums have you been in with crowds present now?
Pittsburgh, I was there. That was great. Last week at Houston, there was... Actually, so it's what's interesting is that there's more fans at these stadiums for the away team. Like last week in Houston, that place was filled with Packer fans.
Yeah.
And I don't know if it's because local folks are selling their tickets for, you know, whatever, and they're having, I mean, it was all Packer fans last week, all Packer fans.
Yeah, well, they can't watch. That's another great example. Like in Wisconsin, they can't watch the Packers play in person. But they can get on planes in Milwaukee mm-hmm. and fly to Texas and watch them play in Houston, which makes no sense.
Yeah, so it was great. Last week was great. Obviously, the Houston Texans, it was a rough game for them. I was on the sideline and just watching J.J. Watt come over every single time. Just, I mean, like, he looked like the Hulk, right? You know how angry the Hulk is?
Yes.
When he, like, is in his Hulk mode, and he's this massive human being, and every time he would come off the field, I just, like, that's the only vision I could see. This weekend, obviously, with Miami, it's very exciting. I got to interview Jason Taylor, when he received his Hall of Fame ring on the sidelines at Miami. It just happened to be scheduled that game. And for someone who grew up a Dolphin fan and someone who, you know, grew up drinking beers in the stadium when I was in college and watching the Dolphins play, to then be on the field with Jason Taylor right after he, you know, gets his Hall of Fame ring, interviewing him live on Fox Sports, it was probably like one of the highlights of my career for sure. So this week, obviously, too, I'm a huge Fitzpatrick fan. I've covered him in a couple of different teams now, and I'm really bummed for him. And I do hope Tua goes out there and does well, because if he doesn't, I think there will be talks about why they made the change. But I'm really excited to see Tua. I think he's a great guy. I've reached out to Nick Saban to try to get some quotes from him about his start and how close they still are and how he handled his rehab and all of that stuff. So I'm going to try to get that in the broadcast as well.
Okay, so what do you expect? I mean, I've met Tua. I know his family. I mean, he is he's just a fantastic kid. He met my 10-year-old. I mean, it was great to spend time around them. I am rooting for him. But it seems like Ryan Fitzpatrick, look, I mean, the Dolphins are 3-3. The Patriots finally stink. That division may be there for the taking. And they're dropping Tua in a pretty tough game against one of the NFL's best defenses so far this year.
Aaron Donald, hello?
Yeah.
I mean,
it's NFL, not exactly, right? An easy way that they're giving him an easy opponent to start with.
No, I mean, welcome to the NFL. Aaron Donald, in your very first start, you have to go against that dude, right? I mean, he's just a beast. And, I think it's going to be – I don't know why they made the decision. I mean, I'm going to read into that, and we'll obviously get to talk to coaches and get to talk to I probably won't get to talk to Ryan Fitzpatrick, but I think he's been really honest about his feelings about this change, which I think is refreshing to hear it. But I think the biggest thing will be that relationship. You know, I saw the Daniel Jones thing when Eli Manning got benched and how that relationship kind of went down. Obviously the Nick Foles and what happened at Chicago with Mitchell Trubisky. I saw how that went down, and it really all depends on how the other guy handles it. I think when Eli handled it the way that he did, everything was okay. I think when, you know, Mitchell Trubisky and Nick Foles have been friends and they worked together, you know, in the preseason that we had, I think that's how it works, right? That's how there's not more stories being told. It's how that other guy handles it. And so we'll see.